Pratibum Havamahe Kavim Kavinam Upamashravastamam Jeshtarajam Brahmanam Brahmanaspatana Ashrumvanu Tivihi Siddhasadhanam Pivakritunda Mahakaya Suryakoti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada Siddhi Buddhi Shakti Sahitam Shrima Mahananadipataye Namo Namaha Nirvignam Kuru Om Ganganapataye Namaha. Namaste everyone. I'm very happy to be here today with my Sanskrit teacher. Maybe you have seen one of my videos saying, oh, my Sanskrit teacher, oh, Randas, oh. So this, we are here, and we are in a very beautiful place. This is Nayar Dam, nearby Shivananda Ashram. So, unfortunately, we are blessed with this scenery to have this conversation. We were taking some Sanskrit classes for 20-25 days in October, November 2019. And during the classes we started talking about the current states of Ayurveda and Sanskrit in India. And I said, look, can we record that? Because this is really good, important information. So first, before we go into the subject itself, this is my teacher. We are studying now from 2 years, more or less. And he is going to present a little bit of his history about his Sanskrit and Ayurveda background. Please, Ananda.
I have completed my post-graduation from Calcutta University, Kerala, in the year 88-90. After that, I have worked in schools for 5 years. After that, 16 years of my service in Ayurveda College. I have read aṣṭānga, hṛdayam, charaka, samhita, and I taught the vyakhyanas for the students of these textbooks. Presently, taking classes for the graduation and post-graduation students, and Tiago is my student for the past 2 years. We had a lot of discussions. He has learned Tantra Yukti from me, to learn application of Tantra Yukti in Jyotisha, in other sciences also. Tantra Yukti is the tool that which is greatly used in research methodology, as well as understanding the textbooks of Indian sciences. Among them, there are books on economy, that is Arthashastra by Kautilya. It is the first textbook to introduce the Tantra Yukti. And after that, all the Ayurvedic textbooks, we have Tantra Yukti as a, one of the very important tool to understand that. And he wanted to know what is the present condition of Ayurveda in India universities as it is being modernized for the graduation and post-graduation courses, where the Indians as well as the Westerners are interested to learn. So there are some modifications have been done in the learning procedures of Ayurveda. It is losing some of the very important aspects of the old, very ancient methodology of learning. Actually, generally, an Ayurvedic scholar in very olden days, he would have been a scholar in the other sciences, especially the Shat Darshanas of the basic scientific textbooks of Indian culture. But now it is missing because the students are coming from plus two, that is the minimum qualification for joining in BMS, and the syllabus are systematized in such a way that it is fit for that students. So, lot of modern anatomy are being added in the Ayurvedic learning. So, Ayurvedic anatomy is somewhat different from the modern anatomy, but it is the need of the hour or need of the century. The children are forced to study modern anatomy in their curriculum. And the importance of the darshanas and the other sciences are very much reduced, and moreover, the textbooks are, original textbooks are written in Sanskrit. There are a lot of descriptions, vyakhyanas in Sanskrit for all the samhitas in Ayurveda, like aṣṭānga hṛdayam, aṣṭānga saṅgraha, charaka samhita, suśruta samhita, etc. But those vyakhyanas are not being practiced or read or referred by the students of the modern BAMS or post-graduation students, because they are getting translations in English.
Okay, this part is important, yes. Please. So, first thing, BAMS is Bachelor in Ayurvedic Medical Science,
yeah.
Right? So, the University of Ayurveda, if you look for this in India, it will be called BAMS. And while we are learning Ashtanga Hridaya, we are mainly studying this book that is known and translated in the West through a commentary that it's only in Devanagari, that is only in Sanskrit. And last time, my wife that is recording this video, she brought me one big red book and I said, okay, good. But my Devanagari is still improving. Now we are learning the Tantra Yukti. This is the hermeneutics of the science. When you're studying philosophy, when you're studying these subjects in a more deeper level, you have to question, how should I learn this this properly? And that's why we started studying Tantra Yukti, because each book of Ayurveda, it can be Sushruta, it can be Ashtanga Hridaya, it can be Charak Samhita. It has its own keys, it has its own hermeneutics, it has its own Tantra Yukti to study. And this should be for any kind of science, any kind of book. So if the person is learning Jyotisha through Parashras, if the person is learning Vastu, or it's learning whatever, Yoga, Hatha, Pradipika, it has to be learned also with a commentary of that book. Because if you only learn with the book itself, probably it's going to be too less information. The books in the Shastras are not developed for you to read. They are developed for you to be taught by a teacher. So now we were studying 36 Tantra Yuktis, yeah, of Ashtanga Hridaya. And now you can say about the problem that you talk with the Ayurvedic teachers and they say, oh, it's all one Tantra Yukti, you don't have to see all these details. And let's go a little bit deeper in the state of what the Ayurvedic teachers in 2019, 2020 think about Sanskrit, and what's the current importance of Sanskrit in the Ayurvedic universe, since you are now in the Amrita School for 16 years.
Actually, the book is written in Sanskrit, and all the tools used there are the learning tools taken from darshanas and the Vedas, etc. And in the scientific aspects, there are shat darshanas, Nyayavisheshika, Sanghiyoka, Purvamimamsa and Uttaramimamsa. All the places, the method of writing a textbook, how to understand a textbook, what is the importance of each word, its derivations, in understanding how to go to the depths of that one, how the suffixes and prefixes can change the meaning, how the context can change the meaning of the word. So many aspects are there. They are all, to great extent, they are missing from the curriculum of Ayurveda now in Indian universities generally. But there are great scholars who follows this method of teaching in the university level also, but they are very few in number because the syllabus is set in such a way. That is the main drawback. Now the BAMS or the post-graduation course suffers in India. And if you take the Tantra Yuktis generally unnote so many secrets of knowledge which are the behind the lines, which are very, very important to understand that. And the Vyakhyanas play a great role because Vyakhyanas were written when the author was there writing the book at that time. There are so many aspects which are not mentioned in the original textbook, but they have to be understood from the Vyakhyanas, which the authors lived at the time of author or nearby the author, and they know the importance of the time and available sources that which are used for Ayurveda. So such a way it was missing, and those Vyakhyanas are not given that much important as the textbooks are translated into English. This is what is really lacking in the university level courses, but there are great scholars even in the villages of India, North India and South India. Family wise they are following that generation to generation, this transformation of the knowledges. In Kerala, if you take Aṣṭānga Hṛdaya is the basic textbook, from generation to generation they hand over with lot of basic knowledges in all other darshana. But in the university level it is somewhat missing because the curriculum is planned in such a way.
So the person that is reading Charaka, for example,
yeah,
and he says, oh, I'm reading Charaka, but he is not reading Bela, he is not reading other samhitas and other vyakanas, other commentaries. He thinks that he can understand Charaka only reading Charaka. So this is one point. The other point is that even if he is reading the Charaka with all the other things that are necessary to be in this proper scheme, it also has to have a teacher to understand.
Certainly.
So one point is important. In the West, we believe that we can read books, and the Indian shastras are not developed in a way that we can understand them fully. Even if we have all the Sanskrit and all the books, if we don't have a teacher to understand, look, this jungle here in this verse is not forest, is a place where there is less water, for this and that sense, the person will read, he will go to the dictionary, Monier Williams there, and going to see jungle and this is forest, and he will think that Vata Jungalam Bhuishtam, it's in the forest, and the person will not have the idea of Adhikarana.
Yeah,
so,
sure.
Let's go to another video now, so Adhikarana.